So today we'll discuss some topics in respiratory system. We have respiratory functions like dead space. What is dead space and what dead space do in your lung? So dead space is the volume of breath that does not participate in the gaseous exchange. Okay, so this is a part of your lung, this is a part in your alveoli which is not taking any part in the gaseous exchange. Gaseous exchange mean that the oxygen and the carbon dioxide which is exchanging at the cellular level. So these are the parts in your lungs which is not taking any part in your gaseous exchange. It is a ventilation without perfusion. Okay, and physiologic or total dead space is the sum of anatomic dead space and alveolar dead space. So what is physiological and total dead space is a total anatomical dead space and alveolar dead space. Okay, so anatomic dead space is a volume of gas within the conducting zone. What is anatomical dead space is a volume of gas within the conducting zone as opposed to the transitional and respiratory zones, and includes the trachea, bronchus, bronchioles and terminal bronchioles. Clear? What is anatomical dead space is a volume of gas within the conducting zone, and it includes trachea, bronchus, bronchiole, terminal bronchiole. It is approximately 2 ml per kg in the upright position. And alveolar dead space is the volume of gas within the unperfused alveoli and does not participating in the gas exchange either. It is usually negligible in the healthy and awake patients. The ratio of physiological dead space to the tidal volume is usually about 1/3. Okay. So what is anatomical dead space? That includes trachea, bronchus, bronchiole, terminal bronchiole, and it is approximately 2 ml per kg in upright position in healthy individual. Okay.